This video is brought to you by Captivating History. Who were the Maya, and why did their thriving civilization suddenly collapse and fail? It is a question that has puzzled historians and explorers for decades, one which has given rise to a variety of theories, none of them entirely adequate. We may never know how and why a people that had endured for thousands of years abruptly vacated cities, colossal temples, farms, and homes, largely disappearing into the annals of history. It is believed that early Mayas arrived in what is present-day Guatemala as early as 11,000 BC, and that they arrived there from Siberia via a land bridge. Over time, these hunter-gatherer tribes grew and expanded into Mexico and parts of Central America. It was not until around 2000 BC, however, that the Maya civilization began to take root and thrive. Following the age of hunter-gatherers, the history of the Maya is defined by five major periods. The pre-classic or formative period, which was marked by the advent of villages and organized agriculture, began around 1800 BC. The pre-classic Maya were more advanced, displaying cultural traits like city construction and pyramid building. Then came the middle pre-classic period, which lasted until about 300 BC. During this period, farmers expanded their presence in the highland and lowland regions and came under the influence of the expanding Olmec Empire. Many aspects of Mayan culture were derived from the Olmecs, including religious and cultural traits, as well as the Maya calendar and number system. The Classic period is also known as the Golden Age. The Golden Age began around 250 AD and lasted until the Terminal Classic, or Period of Disaster, in the late 8th century through the end of the 9th century AD. The period from that time until the early 16th century is known as the Post-Classic period. The earliest Maya spoke a single language, but by the pre-classic period, a diversity of languages had developed. Today, there are 30 Maya languages spoken in modern-day Mexico and Central America. Most of the 5 million or so Maya speakers also speak Spanish. The main seats of Maya civilization were environmentally and culturally diverse. They consisted of Belize and western Honduras, the northern Maya lowlands on the Yucatan Peninsula, the southern lowlands in northern Guatemala and adjacent portions of Mexico, and the southern Maya highlands in the mountainous regions of southern Guatemala. As you might imagine, climate conditions, terrain, water, and other natural resources were just as diverse. The longevity of the Maya civilization is attributed in part to the adaptive abilities and their skill at making the most of what resources were available. The Golden Age saw Maya civilization grow to some 40 cities, including Huazactun, Copan, Tikal, Bonimpac, Calakmul, Palenque, Dos Pilas, and Rio Bec. These cities were heavily populated, the largest of them containing upwards of 50,000 people. At its peak, the Mayan population is thought to have grown to as many as 10 million. The building of massive temples, palaces, housing, and other structures had already commenced. Underground rivers and sinkholes, called cenotes, provided much of the water for personal use and irrigation for the Yucatec Maya. In regions that had no natural water sources, the Maya used ingenuity to supply their large populations. The region they called Puuc, Yucatan Peninsula, was one with no streams, rivers, lakes, or springs. The Maya there used massive systems of cisterns, called chultuns, to collect and store rainwater. In the fabled city of Palenque, which was surrounded by small rivers, Mayas devised vast aqueduct systems that ran beneath the city's walls and streets. The Mayan economy was largely based on agriculture and trade. The crop of premier importance was corn, but the Maya also grew red and black beans, squash, chilies, tobacco, and other crops. Over centuries, they developed and refined irrigation systems and expanded into terraced gardening. The Maya didn't rely on domesticated animals as much as on agriculture, but there is evidence that they raised doves, turkeys, Muscovy ducks, and dogs for food. As trade routes were established between various city-states, the populace grew and flourished. Evidence found in the past few decades indicates that trade was widespread. Artifacts show that many goods were moved considerable distances, despite the difficulties and the lack of beasts of burden. Chemical tests have confirmed that some of these items were transported at great distances. Other goods of trade included such diverse products as cotton mantles, slaves, flint, obsidian, seashells, quetzal feathers, tools, and salt. There were various forms of payment, all of it based on trade rather than monetary units. Smaller purchases were mostly paid for with fish, mace, salt, or any of the other commodities, while larger purchases might be paid with gold, silver, or other luxury goods. The Maya civilization consisted of city-states that encompassed considerable Mesoamerican areas and thousands of square miles. There was no single ruler, rather a collection of lords and kings who zealously guarded their own cities and holdings. Although much of the prosperity of the Mayans was gained through trade, there was also warfare between competing city-states. A military campaign might be launched for a variety of reasons. There were conflicts over control of trade routes, forced compliance with the paying of tributes, and attempts to annex territory through attacks on a bordering state. Little is known about how military organizations were formed or trained. Conflicts are depicted in Maya art from the classic period. Wars and victories are found in hieroglyphic inscriptions, but do not provide information on the causes of war or the form it took. From as early as the pre-classic period, the head of a polity was expected to be a fearless warrior. Some are depicted with trophy heads hanging from their belts. By the time of the classic period, however, trophy heads no longer appeared in such depictions. Rulers are seen as looming threateningly over war captives. Other aspects of Mayan culture included elaborate religious rituals and ceremonies. The Maya believed in blood sacrifice and bloodletting. Rulers, kings, and high priests performed bloodletting rites for every stage in life, every important religious or political event, and for the beginning and end of calendar cycles of any significance. The ancient Mayans believed that the most sacred blood, aside from that of the heart, was from the tongue and the ear. The piercing of ears symbolized an opening to enable the hearing of revelations from the gods. Likewise, piercings of the tongue would allow for speaking those revelations. The Mayans also practiced human sacrifice. Often, the victims were captured in warfare or raids, but they were also selected from the fit young Mayans. In some of the ceremonies, the victim was bound, and a priest or ruler cut open the chest and removed the still-beating heart. This event is depicted on ancient objects and pictorial texts known as codices. These sacrifices were evidently intended to appease or please the various gods, and there were many, most of them tied to nature. The gods of sun, rain, moon, and corn were but a few of the deities important to the Maya. The Maya performed other rituals to satisfy the gods and guarantee some order to the world. There were rituals for marriage, divination, and baptism. These ceremonies often coincided with calendar cycles, days considered holy, but also for special events. A variety of drugs and alcoholic beverages were used in many rituals. Inebriation was believed to be helpful in the widespread practice of divination, a ritual designed to allow direct communication with certain supernatural forces. Inebriation was thought to give one insight to interpret the causes of misfortunes like illness and adverse weather. Unlike the end of the post-classic period, Maya kings took the lead in wars. Maya inscriptions reveal that a defeated king could be kept captive, tortured, and even sacrificed. For the defeated polity, outcomes could vary. Entire cities might be sacked and never resettled, as at Aquateca. In other cases, the victors might seize the defeated noble, along with his family, and imprison or sacrifice them to the gods. At the less severe end of the spectrum, the losing polity would be forced to pay a tribute to the victors. Some historians believe that these internecine conflicts led to the eventual ruin of the civilization. Whatever the reason, much of the empire began to erode toward the end of the 8th century. The cities in the southern lowlands were mysteriously abandoned, and by AD 900, the Maya civilization in that area had collapsed. However, in the highlands of the Yucatan, some cities continued to flourish in the post-classic period. From AD 900 to 1500, the glorious centers of Chichen Itza, Mayapan, and Uxmal continued to bustle with life. In the early 1500s, the Spanish stumbled upon the Maya. But the Spanish conquest of the Maya did not occur until about 20 years later. The Maya fought voraciously against them. It took nearly two centuries for the Spanish to overcome them. In 1697, the last Maya kingdom was taken by the Spanish. While the Spanish introduced some helpful things, such as new crops and animals, the other things they introduced decimated the people. Disease ravaged all of the tribes in the Americas, and the Christian missionaries destroyed nearly all of the Maya codices. Exploration of these sites began in earnest in the 1830s. By the early mid-20th century, some of the hieroglyphic writing contained on those sites had been deciphered, allowing a fascinating glimpse into the history and culture of the Maya. Their writing system is the only one from Mesoamerica to be considerably deciphered by scholars. Excavations within the jungles unearth colossal temples, palaces, plazas, and pyramids, all constructed from solid stone blocks fitted so precisely together that many explorers and historians have wondered if the Mayans had extraterrestrial help. Also fueling that speculation was the almost eerie accuracy of Mayan astronomy and mathematical calculations that included the famous Mayan calendar. Interestingly enough, it was Mayan astronomers who discovered that a year was not 365 days long, but 364.25 days. It was not until 1582 that Europeans stumbled across what the Mayans had known for centuries. The Maya calendar, in its final form, was developed in the 1st century BCE and is still considered the most accurate in existence. It was the early Mayan astronomers that first calculated, correctly, that the journey of Venus through the expanse of the heavens took precisely 583.92 days. Calculations were kept on paper made of bark and carved into stone. Minute recalculations were made and recorded over thousands of years. What happened to the Mayan civilization remains one of the world's most enticing mysteries. There are several competing theories, but they are just that, theories. A previously noted internal warfare between city-states may have led to the breakdowns of societal norms and the eventual collapse of governing systems. That, however, would not explain the sudden departure from populated, well-ordained cities. Some historians hold with the theory of an extreme and prolonged drought or other climate-related disasters, while others postulate a cataclysmic event, like a volcanic eruption or an asteroid colliding with Earth. Yet others theorize that the Maya Empire became overpopulated and simply depleted the resources needed to sustain millions of citizens. The reality is that the demise of the Maya may have resulted from one or more of these theories, or may have had an entirely different cause. We may never know. We do know that a large number of Maya survived those turbulent times. Today, their descendants comprise nearly 40% of the population of Guatemala and still live in modern-day Belize, El Salvador, Honduras, and Mexico. We who visit may marvel at the stunning architecture and the artwork accomplished with rudimentary tools, plant-based dyes, and hand-mined elements. We may experience a moment of terror as we stand at the very stone altar where human hearts were ripped from sacrificial victims, or stare in awe at the cavernous Great Cenote, wondering what secrets and treasures it holds. But to the remaining Maya, this is their history, their passion. This is their heritage, their home, the land of their ancestors. To learn more about Maya history, check out our book, Maya History, A Captivating Guide to the Maya Civilization, Culture, Mythology, and the Maya People's Impact on Mesoamerican History. It's available as an ebook, paperback, and audiobook. Also, grab your free Mythology Bundle ebook while it's still available. All links are in the description. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and subscribe for more videos like this.